Hello and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Manu.
And I'm Paul.
In this video, we'll talk about what to secure. When thinking about the security of your data, there are two important factors to consider. Where is the data and who has access to it? Whether the data is on-premises or in the cloud can be very important from a regulatory perspective or if your company has not yet started using the cloud. This needs to be considered for different data sets and the decision can be impacted by the level of granularity at which you store the data, such as whether you show row-level personally identifiable data or aggregate the data to a higher level. Once you have chosen where to store the data, you also need to consider who you are sharing the data with, which can again come down to the level of granularity. Do you need role-level security so the users have only access to subsets of data, or can you share the report and dashboard publicly? When using data sources in a self-service model with Power BI, there are a number of considerations. You can classify your data to make sure that users understand what they can do with different data sources. At Microsoft, we use low, medium, and high business impact to classify our data. And we have a SharePoint site which details what can be done with each of these different data types. You should think about who has access to data sources. Currently, a user might retrieve and extract of data, but it might save time and effort to give them access to the underlying source. When doing so, you need to consider what level of data they are getting access to. Should they have access to row-level data that might contain personally identifiable information, or should they have access to aggregated data? To aggregate or alter the data, you might need to do some data preparation and maybe give users access to that model rather than the underlying source so that they don't need to understand the relationships or other complexities. Common data sources are Excel and CSV files, which is how most customers start to use Power BI while they consider the implementation of governance on corporate data sources. You might want to provide guidance on how to connect to data sources, including Excel and CSV files, and how security can be applied within the Power BI data model. The fun thing here is, I'm sure you've worked with people who used to export reports to Excel, and now with Power BI, we are seeing people doing this the other way around.
When connecting to data with Power BI, the location of the data is important for performance and for when you come to scheduling a refresh. If the data is on-premises, you need to plan for installing a Power BI gateway. Do you need to use a personal gateway? Or if this is for a wider audience, do you need to install an on-premises gateway? Then you need to consider where you're going to install it and how many of them you require. For some data sources, you need to think about how you're going to connect to the data. If you're connecting to a database or analysis services, do you want to connect using direct or live query so you can always see the latest version of the data? Or do you want to connect to various data sources and combine and mash up this data, in which case you can use import mode and then schedule a refresh to occur to meet your user requirements. There are two types of model based on the two ways to connect to the data sources. A cloud model is where the data and metadata are stored in Power BI. This will be data from data sources like flat files, online sources, or streaming data sources, but could also be from databases. When creating or refreshing a model, a cache of the data at that point in time is taken. You can then schedule a refresh to get the latest version of the data. An external model is where only the metadata is stored in Power BI, and the data exists in an external source. This would be using direct query to a database, or using live query to connect to an analysis services model, either on-premises or in Azure. When connecting with direct or live query, no data from the source is imported into Power BI Desktop. Each time you interact with a visualization, Power BI queries the data source and calculates the results you see. So you're always looking at the latest data whilst interacting with the report. With composite models, you can combine data from more than one direct query source, or combine direct query with imported data as well. We've included a link to the slides used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment. See you in the next one.